Merry Christmas Eve, and thank you guys for the time off, but I can't take it because we have Christmas chaos. This happening now. Don't even try to fly out here to visit Will and I because you're not going to be able to make it. All flights canceled. And cue the fire. We have so many stories to go over. And if I take a day off, you won't have someone to go over like gold. Oh my gosh. Do you see what's happening with gold? Do you see what's happening with Bitcoin? Bitcoin is always trading. And you have people like Tom Lee said that the market's going to go up in the next, I don't know how many, 300 and something percent. These are things that we need to be looking at. And also, speaking of looking at, if for some reason you have duck phobias and you're choosing to fly this Christmas, remember, he's always watching you. You can run, but you can never hide. But we also have a couple more stories. Like another strategist says that, you know, this little upsies that we've had in the market, it's not. It's going to sell off hard. But then my little green thing that I drew for you, then Christmas rally, which let me zoom in for you. Santa, look at that. We're not there. So just wait, just maybe sell off. And then we got 10 days of Christmas gifts. And I drew it there just for you and I left it. I'm like, that is your zone. And here is the story. Some strategists see shades of Christmas past in sell-off. You're like, what? What said sell-off? You need to wait. And then what? A rebound ahead. And then what the heck? An N95 mask? I thought they'd 15 days. Again, it's been 2 years and I'm still... I'm not coming out of my mom's basement. You guys need to get a handle on this and then let me know when I can come out. They also say, and I'm not a doctor, I don't know, they say this new strain's just like the cold. Huh. Just like the common cold. That's weird. Holidays? Cold? The biggest reason to stay bullish is because of millennials. This is what I also wanted to talk to you guys about. Tom Lee. And I'm sure my screen's going to shake. No? A little bit. A little shaky on the fingers. That's actually... Christmas morning, right? Because you drank too much on Christmas Eve, then you get the shakes. Mom, Dad, what's wrong with you? Nothing. We're good over here. Soaring by 313%. You just looks like you got to wait a few years for it. And I've actually been in that S&P for like 20-something years. I think 25, 23 years. Haven't touched that thing. I had to scroll down for the Getty image on this one. Look at that. That's you waiting. 10 years. And I say, why would you wait 10 years for 300%? You have Bitcoin. You could do that in a weekend. I mean, you could lose it in a weekend too. So we need to look at, we're going to look at Bitcoin. You're going to love my gold. Oh, I am so excited. I got TA just oozing out of me today. And what I've done for you, I've made some really pretty colors for those of you in my audience that like pretty colors on Bitcoin. We have some good news and we have some bad news. What do you want first? Let's do the good news. So let me zoom in for you. And I think I got to get rid of the colors. That's just, is that a little threatening? Okay. I hid the Fibonacci for you. First one, let's head over to this. See this on the left side? It's my left side. I don't know if it's your left side. Left shoulder, huh? Head, right shoulder. And then we fell. There's your neckline. And if you want me to measure it for you, I will. See, we go from here all the way down there. Ha! Huh? Look at that. Perfect measured move. See that little blue arrow? That's where Bravo said he puts in buy. And everyone was like, no, we're going to a trillion billion. Okay, so, and then you're like, where do I sell? Well, then you do the little Fibonacci there, and it was actually pulled right there. That is the golden pocket. And I said, I am going to hold my breath, and that was a hard one. It was like your little brother, your older brother, holding your head under the water for at least 10 minutes. I mean, I was itching to get out of that position. I'm like, come on. Wait for it. All right. So then exited position. No, Bravo. Okay. So now we start this fun little thing called the left shoulder right there. We drop. Okay. Now we have a head. Do you see this up here? Head, left shoulder, up, right shoulder. Also, this is perfectly lined up. And let me grab my Fibonacci for you. Let me pull this down, which I just originally had it. And then I delete it because it's too messy. Right there. See this? That's your golden pocket. What are the probabilities that said Bitcoin will go up to said golden pocket and sell off? So I will leave that. I will take those colors out. Also, left shoulder, right shoulder. Now, hold on. There's still money to be made. I call them a little quick in and out smash and grabs. I'm originally from LA, so I know how that goes down. Looking at this, I told you I exited there. I re-entered right at that line, and then I closed my position a few days ago before this monumental pump that you guys are... But see this yellow line? Critical. And let me turn on the KC for you so you can see it. When we go in and out of this thing, which we're currently in it, okay? You're out of it. You're in it. You have nice runs. And that is the yellow-blue line. I guess they're kind of mixing there. That is the 20. So possible gains. I don't know if you're going to get this, but when we enter said on top of yellow, the 20, your gain on that from peak to trough was 53%. And the last measured move, and hold on, I'll get to gold in just a minute. You guys are going to be really excited about this one. The last measured move on this one was 60%. Also, link in the description. That's below me. You got to click more and you'll see a coupon, like a link. It'll make this course that I teach everyone, college students, high school kids get a little like, what is this? They're better swing trade. This is more TA. It'll say university. This is the one for 200. So smash and grab that one before it goes away, which we're done, right? Christmas, it's over. All my sales, kapoof. So let's see. I've given you the good news, right? You had 50%, another 50%. That's 100%. Beats Tom Lee. You have to wait till 2059. Buying SPY, which is totally fine. That's me too. Slow and steady will win the race. Also, none of this is financial advice, just paper trade. You'll lose nothing. But going back to a couple things, we had that falling wedge. We broke out of it. I said, when we break out, I will put in a buy. I did. I put in a buy and then I got out. These are called my smash and grab scenarios because there is some fear. And if by any chance I drink enough spiked eggnog, I might take out a position on this, but it's a short one. Don't think like, oh, ha, you just got wrecked. I will tell you right here, willy-nilly, 51,000, one Bitcoin, exit before golden pocket. That would be 54,000. And then take the $3,000 off the table. Now, where said stop loss? Because now this is where the you comes in. You hit 44, I'm out. So it's like 50-50 ratio. Now let's talk, what are the probabilities of some really bad news playing out? All right, step number one, top of head, left shoulder, form right shoulder, golden pocket, get rejected, do measured move from neckline. That would put my trade, if I decide I'm just going to buy and hold, all the way down to 20,000, which happened back that way. And everyone said, even though they look so much alike, look, compare these things, follow the lines. Same, you're like, oh, get in. Oh, get wrecked. Crypto is like petting piranhas. You're like, oh, how cute. Ow. And also, for those of you that would like to know what the year-to-date performances of my assets, and again, people throw rocks at me and all, I just come balanced. You're like, I hate Bitcoin. I love gold. Well, it depends on where we're at. Now, just a moment, I'm going to show you why I love gold. Watch this. So Bitcoin was up 73% this year. Congratulations. I will take that. And you actually can take a whole lot more than 73% if you know how to trade patterns, but it's very difficult. S&P 500, I made 28%. I have not touched that. Gold down 7%. Oh no, but I thought Fed go burr. I know, so confusing. But wait, there's more. Silver down almost 20%. But I think 2022, is that where we're moving into? I think gold's gonna shine, baby. And I did say I think. Again, I'm a trader. I look at charts. I don't listen to everyone like, blah, blah, blah. I think this and I think that. And I think variant will lock us all down and we're all going to die. Like, I don't know. I just look at the chart and I will tell you when I've been exited. You know, I was exited all year on gold. I don't know how many trades I even made of gold, but there is a change. There are winds of change. Now on this chart, ooh. Even that, look at that confluence. See where we're at? We're above? Hold on, let's clear some things. Also, for those of you who are like, oh, those are new. What is that? It's like intestines. Oh, those must be Bollinger Bands. They're actually not. If you guys want, go right up here, indicators and strategies, type in KC, and it's Keltner channels. But I am going to get rid of said Keltner, make him go away. I will leave the 21. Do I leave the 20, 21 up? You guys see it. See how we're on top of it? That's bullish. So you got one bull down. Let me get rid of that. Okay, clear that up. I have a blue line there. I don't know what I was measuring, but I'm sure it was important. And if you are new to trading, it's the 200-day moving average. Turn that little bad boy on. Actually, you can turn off. See the blue? That one's blue. I have one in my course on swing trading. it comes on. It's the 180. That way you can beat all the algorithms, but then it confuses normal traders. You're like, why are we off? So here we are on gold. I have my 180, my 200-day moving average, and I have my Bravo 9. If we were to take, this is so exciting, see this measured move? Oh my goodness. Say it isn't so, Bravo. At some point, I think we're in that, we're coming out of that apex. And this is where it gets exciting. What is this? Oh, that's at the top again. Oh, some resistance. Okay. So double your money. Well, that's if you leverage. Don't leverage. Don't do that. Okay. So zooming in, let's go right here and take a look. Oh, my gold friends are so excited. Okay. So on the swing trade right there, see, we get the beat down, huh? One candle close above, we ride. And this is so exciting because I love gold. Look right here. There it is. 1,811 doll hairs. Now, if we break that green line, just paper trading, you right click and then you close your position. And here's just a thought, gift to you, right? Learn how to trade this year. So there you go. That's enter. Exit. Now, this is willy-nilly. Take profit there. Wait for said beatdown because you know there's resistance. Buy there. And then re-enter here and then moon. Also, just to let you know, for those of you that follow that, see that? Oh, I drew it. I'm like, you're going to forget. You have a bullish divergence here. See this line on the MACD, the oscillator going up. Price going down. Which was that blue line that I had drawn and my brain didn't get it? See, it's like the older you get, Sherlock, I become Sherlock Holmes. I'm like, why did I leave this yellow sticky on the refrigerator? It says, go buy wife a card for Christmas. I'm like, when's Christmas? I got it. You want to see it before she does? Yeah, she doesn't watch my videos, so here it is, babe. We kind of have a tradition where she gets to shop all year long, but I don't have to buy her anything on Christmas. And looking at the RSI, look, oh, go-go juice going up. Anything above that 50 in that direction, that is good. The Nifty 50, which that's trader speak. Nifty 50 pullback comes to a halt. Also, once again, isn't it nice that you're learning charts? Even if you don't pay $200 for my course on sale, you're like, I will just subscribe. Okay, I will learn from everything that you say. Okay, Larry Summers predicts the future. And it doesn't look good. Larry's kind of a smart guy. I mean, he did work for the Treasury under, was it Clinton? And he did get the whole inflation thing correct. But what do we do when you're conflicted? Because on one side, these guys say it's all going to fire. And then these guys all say it's going to the moon. And then you head over to Bloomberg stocks. They'll tell you why. They end volatile week at record high on confidence. Because you guys are so confident in this economy. And I say, la, 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 I'm not listening to you. Like, just throw the TVs out the window. If you guys even watch, do you guys even watch TV? I don't watch TV. That is like propaganda. You guys think I'm doom and gloom? You should try CNN for a minute. Try anything for a minute. I mean, even last night, our waitress was like, you know, all covered and freaked out. We're all gonna die. You haven't heard the news? My wife's like, my husband doesn't let me watch the news. Well, we're all going to be locked down and we can't do anything forever. I'm like, dang it. I knew I shouldn't have came out of my mom's basement. And honestly, I just come out, I grab a little food and then I head back in. I do my trades. And then you don't have to, look at this Bitcoin, 73%. God, I mean, ow, that really hurt when you hit your fingers on the desk. But the people would have told you all in gold, all in silver. And you're like, oh, shoot. And what you need to be all in on is stuff in here so you can do it. You don't have to listen to other people, although they train you to. Just follow the rules. What does the textbook say? Yes, sir. I mean, actually, you probably know you have problems when CNN starts bagging on Brandon. They're like, yeah, he seems confused. CNN openly questions President's cognitive health after yet another slip up. I mean, probably not the kind of guy that you want slipping up when you have things like Russia blames Ukraine for act of terrorism after consulate attack. You guys copying us or something? That is like by the book on how to go to war. No, well, the good news is I will tell you what's going on. That's why you subscribed and you can figure this all out and why maybe you, oh wait, you did that. You already did that. You don't, computer, oh, you did not do that. So I would really appreciate if you could hit that and I will see, oh my gosh, tomorrow's Christmas. Eh? Am I going to see you tomorrow? We will see.